Today we're going to talk about fractions and how to add them.
Vega Vega?
Fractions are part of a whole. Piraso lang sila na one whole. If this is one pizza, then this is a fraction of the pizza. At ang tawag sa fraction na to is one half. This is also a fraction of the pizza. At ang tawag sa fraction na to is one fourth.
Whoa.
Fractions, especially the ones called proper fractions, are smaller than one whole. Mas maliit sila sa one whole. Fractions are named using two numbers, the numerator and the denominator. The denominator tells how many pieces the one whole was divided. Ilan ba yung hati sa one whole pizza? 4. The numerator tells how many pieces are actually here. Ilan yung slice ng pizza na nandito? 3. So our fraction is 3/4. For example, a blue circle was divided into 6 and only 5 pieces are here. So this fraction of the circle is called 5/6. Another example, this red rectangle was divided into 5 and only 2 pieces are here. So this fraction of the rectangle is called 2/5. Madali lang, di ba?
Hard work!
Equivalent fractions are fractions that have different numerators and denominators, but they have the same value. This portion of a pizza is represented by the fraction 3/4. Divided into 4, 3 pieces are here. This portion of a pizza is represented by the fraction 6/8. Divided into 8, 6 pieces are here. Do they have the same amount of pizza? Yes, they do. Therefore, 3/4 and 6/8 are equivalent fractions.
In my head, I saw that differently.
Another example is this piece of cheese. It is represented by the fraction 1/2. Divided into 2, 1 piece is shown. This piece of cheese is represented by the fraction 4/8. Divided into 8, 4 pieces are shown. Do they have the same amount of cheese? Yes, they do. Therefore, 1/2 and 4/8 are equivalent fractions. But what do we do with equivalent fractions? The rule says that we must choose the simpler version of equivalent fractions for our final answer. This is also called the lowest term. Kung alin yung mas maliit yung numbers, yun lang ang pwedeng gamitin sa final answer. So, between 3/4 and 6/8, we will use 3/4 kasi yun yung lowest term. Pareho lang naman sila ng value, di ba? So, we must always use the lowest term of fractions.
What do you mean?
If you're given a fraction with a big numerator and a big denominator, you must always check if this is in the lowest term. If not, you must reduce it to its lowest term. Kapag kasi hindi lowest term ang final answer nyo, mamalian kayo ng teacher nyo. Pero paano ba i-reduce yung mga fraction sa lowest term? By checking the divisibility of the numerator and denominator. I-divide natin yung numerator and denominator with the same number, kung meron. Kapareho lang ito ng continuous division, pero fraction yung itsura. Do you remember continuous division? I hope so.
I think not!
For example, we have the fraction 6/8. Anong number ang pwedeng ipang-divide sa 6 and 8? Try natin yung 2. So 6 divided by 2 equals 3. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. Wala nang pwedeng i-divide sa 3, so stop na tayo. And our fraction 6/8 is now reduced to its lowest term, 3/4. Another example, say we have 16 over 20. We will reduce this to its lowest term. Anong pwedeng ipang-divide sa 16 tsaka 20? Try natin yung 2. 16 divided by 2 equals 8. 20 divided by 2 equals 10. So, 16 over 20 is now 8 over 10. Pero meron pa to. Anong pwedeng ipang-divide sa 8 saka sa 10? Try ulit natin yung 2. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. 10 divided by 2 equals 5. Wala nang pwedeng i-divide sa 5, so stop na tayo. And our fraction 16 over 20 is now reduced to its lowest term, 4/5.
Hard work!
For your practice, I will show you a few pictures. You will just tell me what fraction represents the colored parts of each picture. Each picture will be shown for 5 seconds only. Pero pwede nyong i-pause yung video para matitigan nyo sila ng mabuti. And of course, you must have your final answers in lowest term. So check nyo kung pwedeng i-reduce to lowest term. Okay? Ready? Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Number 1 is 5/8. Wala naman pwedeng ipang divide sa 5, so this is in its lowest term. Number 2 is 2/9. Wala naman pwedeng ipang divide sa 2, so this is in its lowest term. Number 3 is 3/6, but this is not in its lowest term. We can divide 3 and 6 by 3. 3 divided by 3 equals 1. 6 divided by 3 equals 2. So the correct fraction in the lowest term is 1/2. Number 4 is 12 over 16, but this is not in its lowest term. We can divide 12 and 16 by 2. 12 divided by 2 equals 6. 16 divided by 2 equals 8. Pwede pa rin i-divide yung 6 saka 8 by 2. So 6 divided by 2 equals 3. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. Hindi na pwedeng i-divide yung 3, so stop na tayo. And the correct fraction in its lowest term is 3/4.
In my head, I saw that differently.
Tip lang, kung kaya nyo. Yung 12 over 16, pwede nating i-reduce yun to lowest term by dividing by 4. 12 divided by 4 equals 3. 16 divided by 4 equals 4. So, the answer is 3/4. Hindi natin kailangan dalawang beses mag-divide by 2. Kung kaya nyo mag-divide by 4, sige lang, mas mabilis yun. Make sure lang na alam nyo yung ipang di-divide nyo. For example, sa 24 over 36, pwedeng 4 yung ipang divide nyo. Pwede ring 6. Pwede ring 12. Basta tuloy-tuloy na lang hanggang maging lowest term na yung fraction. Okay? I hope you understand that. Now you already know that this pizza is represented by the fraction 3/4. But what about this figure? One whole pizza and 3/4. We can call this 1 3/4. What about this? 2 cakes and 1/2 cake. We can call this 2 1/2. 1 3/4, 2 1/2. When a whole number in a fraction is combined, they are called mixed numbers. So can you tell me what mixed number represents this figure? Correct. It's 3 1/3. What about this? You will have to reduce this to its lowest term. Correct. It's 5 1/2. Kanina, it's 5 2/4. Pag nireduce mo sa lowest term, 5 1/2. That is easy, right? Now, the usual fractions have their numerators smaller than their denominators. Like 1/2, 3/4, 5/8. This is the proper way because denominators tell how many pieces the one whole was cut. And the numerators tell how many pieces are counted. Natural na mas marami yung hati ng one whole kaysa sa pieces na nandyan. And these fractions are called proper fractions. Now in some instances, we can see fractions with bigger numerators compared to their denominators. Like 5/4, 3/2, 6/3, etc. Hindi natural ang ganito. Imagine nyo na lang kung paano i-represent ng ganitong mga fractions ang mga figures na ginagamit natin. Like pizza, saka yung cake.
Wow.
Paano nga ba? Magulo, diba? Mamaya i-explain ko. But for now, ang tawag sa ganitong mga fractions ay improper fractions. So these are proper fractions, and these are improper fractions. Okay? So kanina hindi natin ma-imagine kung paano i-represent ng improper fraction sa mga real objects like pizza or cake, etc. Try natin yung 5 fourths sa pizza. This is 1 fourth. 1 piece from the original 4 slices. Try natin yung limang ganito. 5 fourths, diba? 5 piraso. Ano nangyari? Diba naging mixed number yung pizza? Remember mixed numbers? So, ano mixed number ito? It's 1 and 1 fourth. So, in mathematics, we can change improper fractions para maging mixed numbers sila. We can change 5 fourths para maging 1 and 1 fourth siya. Paano? By division. The numerator 5 is the dividend. The denominator 4 is the divisor. Palaging ganyan. Yung numerator yung nasa loob. So 5 divided by 4 equals 1, remainder 1. Yung quotient, yun yung magiging whole number ng mixed number. That's 1. Tapos yung remainder na 1, yun yung magiging numerator sa mixed number. At yung original denominator na 4, yun yung magiging denominator na mixed number. So our mixed number is 1 and 1 fourth. Galing yan sa 5 fourths na ikinonvert natin. Do you understand?
I think not!
Isa pang example. Say we have 26 over 8. This is an improper fraction. Huwag na tayo mag-drawing ng pizza at cake. Numbers na lang. Gets nyo naman siguro yung numbers. So, anong gagawin natin to convert this improper fraction to mixed number? We will divide. 26 divided by 8 equals 3, remainder 2. So, yung quotient na 3 will be the whole number of the mixed number. Yung remainder na 2 will be the numerator of the mixed number. Tapos, we will just use the old denominator 8. So, we will have 3 and 2 8s. Is this correct? Tapos na ba? Hindi pa. 2 8s is not in its lowest term. So, i-reduce natin siya sa lowest term. Anong pwedeng ipang divide sa 2 and 8? Ano pa nga ba? Eh, di 2. 2 divided by 2 equals 1. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. So, our fraction is now 1 fourth. And our mixed number is now 3 and 1 fourth. Okay, kayo naman. Mag-practice naman kayo. Convert the following improper fractions to mixed numbers. Gayahin nyo lang yung examples. Division lang, tapos aayusin nyo lang yung remainder. Ready? Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Number 1. 5/3. We will divide the numerator by the denominator. 5 divided by 3 equals 1, remainder 2. So 1 is the whole number, 2 is the numerator, and the old denominator 3 is the denominator. So 5/3 is equals to 1 and 2/3. Number 2, 12 over 7. We will divide. 12 divided by 7 is equals to 1, remainder 5. So 1 is the whole number, 5 is the numerator, and the old denominator 7 is the new denominator. So 12 over 7 equals 1 and 5 sevenths. Number 3, 13 over 5 or 13 fifths. We will divide. 13 divided by 5 equals 2, remainder 3. So 2 is the whole number, 3 is the numerator, and the denominator is 5. So 13 fifths is equals to 2 and 3 fifths. Number 4. 15 over 6. We will divide 15 by 6. 15 divided by 6 equals 2, remainder 3. So 2 is the whole number, 3 is the numerator, and 6 is the denominator. So 15 over 6 is equals to 2 and 3 sixths. Pero hindi pa tapos ito. We must reduce 3 6 to its lowest term. 3 and 6 are divisible by 3. So 3 divided by 3 equals 1. 6 divided by 3 equals 2. So the correct fraction is 1 half. and the correct mix number is 2 and 1 half. Do you understand? I hope so. Now there are fractions with the same denominators. There are also fractions with different denominators. Fractions with the same denominators are called similar fractions. Fractions with different denominators are called dissimilar fractions. Gets nyo ba? Dissimilar. Dissimilar. Hindi similar. Hehehe.
Settle down, are you kidding?
Anyway, wala naman masyadong problema kung similar sila or dissimilar. Kung pareho man yung denominators nila o hindi. Maliban na lang kung i-add mo sila. To add similar fractions, we just add the numerators and use the common denominator as the denominator of the sum. I-add lang daw yung numerators, tapos kukopyahin yung common denominators ng dalawa at hindi i-add yung denominators. But here's the catch. According to the rules, you can only add similar fractions. Hindi nyo pwedeng i-add yung dissimilar fractions. So, paano tayo mag-a-add ng dissimilar fractions? Mamaya na natin problemahin yon. Unahin natin yung addition of similar fractions. So, for example, 1/5 plus 2/5. I-add lang daw natin yung numerators. So, 1 plus 2 equals 3. Tapos, kukunin natin yung common denominator na 5. So, our answer is 3/5. Ang dali, di ba?
Hard work!
How about 3/5 and 4/5? How do we add this? Again, i-add natin yung numerators. 3 plus 4 equals 7. Tapos, kukunin natin yung common denominator na 5. So, the answer is 7/5. But this is not yet the final answer. Improper fraction kasi to. Mamalian ni teacher ito. Kailangan pa natin itong i-convert sa mixed number. Paano nga ba yun? By dividing. 7 divided by 5 equals 1 remainder 2. 1 is our whole number, 2 is our numerator, and 5 is our denominator. So our final answer is 1 2/5.
In my head, I saw that differently.
Another example. Say we have 3/8 plus 1/8. Again, i-add lang natin yung numerators. 3 plus 1 equals 4. Kukunin natin yung common denominator na 8. So our answer is 4 over 8. But this is not yet the final answer. Hindi siya improper fraction pero hindi naman siya lowest term. Kailangan natin siyang i-reduce. Paano? Alam nyo na yun, di ba? Parang continuous division lang, remember? Anong pwedeng ipang-divide sa 4 tsaka sa 8? Ayoko mag-divide sa 2 ng dalawang beses, so 4 na lang. 4 divided by 4 equals 1. 8 divided by 4 equals 2. And the final answer is 1/2. Ganun lang yon, okay? Like I said, according to rules, we can only add similar fractions. So kung mag-a-add tayo ng hindi similar fractions, kailangan gawin muna natin silang similar. Kailangan gumawa tayo ng paraan. Anong paraan? There are two techniques that we can use. The first one is called cross multiplication. The second one, we can use LCD or least common denominator. Unahin natin yung cross multiplication. Suppose we have 3/4 and 1/6. Hindi similar ang mga fractions na to. Magkaiba yung denominators nila. What we will do is multiply ng pa-cross, the numerator of the first fraction times the denominator of the second fraction. 3 times 6 equals 18. Ilalagay natin dito. Then we will multiply the denominator of the first fraction times the numerator of the second fraction. 4 times 1 equals 4. Ilalagay naman natin dito. And then we will multiply the denominators. 4 times 6 equals 24. Ilalagay natin sa ilalim ng dalawang nakuha natin. Under both of them para maging similar fractions sila. 18 over 24 tsaka 4 over 24. And since similar fractions na sila, pwede na natin silang i-add. Add the numerators only. 18 plus 4 equals 22. And our answer will be 22 over 24. All we need to do now is to reduce this to its lowest term. Divisible ang 22 and 24 sa 2. 22 divided by 2 equals 11. 24 divided by 2 equals 12. So our final answer is 11 over 12. Madali lang, di ba?
I don't think so.
Ang problema lang sa technique na to, you will usually get big numbers because of the multiplications. Pero pwede namang i-reduce yung mga yon to lowest terms. The second technique is by using the LCD or least common denominator. Ang LCD ay kapareho lang ng LCM. Pero yung mga denominators ang tinitingnan natin. So, tinawag siyang least common denominator. Say you have 3/4 plus 1/6. Tingnan natin yung denominators, 4 and 6. Kukunin natin yung LCD ng 3/4 and 1/6 by finding the LCM of 4 and 6. Basta kukunin natin yung LCM ng 4 and 6. We can use scratch paper para hanapin ito using continuous division. Pero pwede rin naman mag-enumerate na lang tayo ng multiples. Maliit lang naman yung 4 tsaka 6. So the multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16. And the multiples of 6 are 6, 12, diba? Ang bilis lang. So the LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. And 12 is our LCD. Aayusin natin dyan ang ganito. Common denominator siya ng mga bagong fractions natin. Babaguhin kasi natin yung 3/4 tsaka 1/6. Next, i-divide natin yung LCD sa old denominators ng mga original fractions. Tapos, i-multiply natin yung sagot sa numerators. The result will be our new numerators.
What do you mean?
Ganito yun. 12 divided by 4 equals 3. 3 times 3 equals 9. So, 3/4 becomes 9 over 12. Next, 12 divided by 6 equals 2. 2 times 1 equals 2. So, 1/6 becomes 2 over 12. Now, the fractions are already similar. Pwede na natin silang i-add. We add the numerators only. 9 plus 2 equals 11. Tapos, kukunin natin yung LCD na 12. So, our final answer is 11 over 12. It's up to you kung aling technique yung gagamitin nyo. Pareho rin naman yung magiging sagot if you do each one correctly. Basta huwag kayong gagamit ng techniques na to kung proper naman yung fractions na i-add nyo. Okay? Para lang sa dissimilar fractions ito.
So I'll just do it again.
Okay, now you try it. Add the following fractions. Dalawa yung similar, dalawa yung dissimilar. Kung improper fraction yung lalabas na sagot, convert it to mixed number. Kung pwedeng i-reduce to lowest terms, i-reduce nyo. Ready?
Let's do this!
Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Number 1. 3/7 plus 1/7. Similar sila, so we just add the numerators and copy the common denominator. So 3 plus 1 equals 4. And the answer is 4 over 7. Number 2. 5/8 plus 7/8. Similar din sila. So we also add the numerators and copy the common denominator. 5 plus 7 equals 12. And we have 12 over 8. This is an improper fraction, so we will convert this to a mixed number. We will divide 12 by 8. 12 divided by 8 equals 1, remainder 4. So our mixed number is 1 and 4 eighths. But this is not final yet. 4 eighths can be reduced to its lowest term. We can divide 4 and 8 by 4. 4 divided by 4 equals 1. 8 divided by 4 equals 2. So 4 eighths becomes 1 half. And our final answer is 1 and 1 half. Number 3. 1/6 plus 3/8. These are dissimilar fractions. I will use LCD on 1/6 and 3/8. What is the LCM of 6 and 8? We will use continuous division. 6 and 8 is divisible by 2. 6 divided by 2 equals 3. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. Wala nang pwedeng i-divide sa 3, so stop na tayo. We will multiply 2 times 3 times 4 equals 24. So our LCM, which is the same as our LCD, is 24. Next, babaguhin natin yung mga fractions natin. 24 divided by 6 equals 4. 4 times 1 equals 4. So 1/6 becomes 4 over 24. Then 24 divided by 8 equals 3. 3 times 3 equals 9. So 3 over 8 becomes 9 over 24. Ayan, similar fractions na sila. Then we will add by adding only the numerators. 4 plus 9 equals 13. We will copy the LCD, 24. And our final answer is 13 over 24. Lowest term na yan kasi wala naman pwedeng i-divide sa 13. Number 4, 2/3 plus 1/6. The similar fractions ulit. This time, I will use cross multiplication. So 2 times 6 equals 12. 3 times 1 equals 3. For our common denominator, 3 times 6 equals 18. Similar fractions na sila. So i-add na natin sila. Numerators lang. 12 plus 3 equals 15. We will copy the LCD, which is 18. So we have 15 over 18. But this is not in its lowest term. 15 and 18 can be divided by 3. So 15 divided by 3 equals 5. 18 divided by 3 equals 6. And our final answer is 5/6. Did you get everything correct? I hope so. Tsaga-tsaga lang naman yan, di ba? Now, what if you have to add two mixed numbers? Anong gagawin nyo? There are two techniques to do this. The first one is to convert the mixed numbers to improper fractions. We add them and then convert them back to mixed numbers. Gagawin natin improper fractions, yung mixed numbers, i-add natin, tapos ibabalik natin sa mixed number. For example, we have 4 and 3 fifths plus 7 and 1 fifths. Iko-convert natin sila sa mixed number. Uunahin natin yung 4 and 3 fifths. We multiply the denominator with the whole number. 5 times 4 equals 20. Then we will add the answer with the numerator. 20 plus 3 equals 23. This now will become our numerator. And we will use the old denominator, 5. So we will have 23 over 5. So 4 and 3 fifths becomes 23 over 5. Gawin naman natin yon sa 7 and 1 fifth. 5 times 7 equals 35. 35 plus 1 equals 36. We use the denominator 5 and we have 36 over 5. Ayan, similar fractions na sila. Pwede na natin silang i-add. 23 over 5 plus 36 over 5. We add the numerators. 23 plus 36 equals 59. And so we have 59 over 5. Improper fraction yan. So kailangan natin convert sa mixed number. So 59 divided by 5 equals 11, remainder 4. So 11 is our whole number, 4 is our numerator, and 5 is our denominator. Our final answer is 11 and 4 fifths.
Hard work!
Another example. Say we have 2 and 1 half plus 3 and 1 fourth. First, i-convert natin sila sa improper fraction. 2 times 2 equals 4. 4 plus 1 equals 5. So 2 and 1 half becomes 5 halves. Next, 4 times 3 equals 12. 12 plus 1 equals 13. So 3 and 1 fourth becomes 13 over 4. So now we have 5 halves plus 13 fourths. Dissimilar fractions naman sila. So magko-cross multiply ako. 5 times 4 equals 20. 2 times 13 equals 26. For our denominator, 2 times 4 equals 8. Ayan, similar fractions na sila. 20 over 8 plus 26 over 8. Let's add the numerators. 20 plus 26 equals 46. We copy the common denominator 8. We will have 46 over 8. This is an improper fraction, so we will convert it to mixed number. We will divide 46 over 8 equals 5, remainder 6. So we have 5 and 6 eighths. Hindi pa tapos yan. Pwede pang i-reduce to lowest term yung 6 over 8. 6 and 8 can be divided by 2. 6 divided by 2 equals 3. 8 divided by 2 equals 4. So we have 3/4. And our final answer is 5 3/4. Mahirap ba?
Pico, wake up!
Tsaga-tsaga lang, okay? The second technique is to add the whole numbers separately and then add the fractions separately and then combine the results. Say we have 4 3/5 plus 7 1/5. We add the whole numbers. 4 plus 7 equals 11. We add the fractions. 3/5 plus 1/5. Similar fractions sila, so walang problema. We add the numerators. 3 plus 1 equals 4. We copy the denominator 5. And we have 4/5. Then we will combine our answer to the whole number and our answer to the fractions. 11 saka 4/5. And our final answer is 11 4/5.
Whoa.
Another example. Say we have 2.5 plus 3 1/4. We add the whole numbers. 2 plus 3 equals 5. We add the fractions. 1/2 plus 1/4. These are dissimilar fractions, so I will use LCD. Ano ba yung LCM ng 2 and 4? Shortcut ito, double-double, diba? So kapag double yung isang number ng isang number, ang LCM ay yung mas malaki, 4. So babaguhin natin yung fractions gamit yung 4. 4 divided by 2 equals 2. 2 times 1 equals 2. So 1/2 becomes 2/4. Hindi na natin babaguhin yung 1/4 kasi 4 na yung denominator niya. So 2/4 plus 1/4. We add the numerators. 2 plus 1 and we have 3/4. Then we will combine our two answers, 5 3/4. And our final answer is 5 3/4.
In my head, I saw that differently.
Another example. Say we have 1 3/5 plus 2 4/5. We add the whole numbers. 1 plus 2 equals 3. We add the fractions. Similar sila kaya madali lang to. 3/5 plus 4/5. We add the numerators. 3 plus 4 equals 7. So we have 7/5. This is an improper fraction, so we convert to mixed number. We divide 7 divided by 5 equals 1, remainder 2. 7/5 becomes 1 2/5. Then we combine our two answers, 3 and then 1 2/5. Combine means add, so we add the whole numbers 3 and 1. 3 plus 1 equals 4, and our final answer is 4 2/5. It's up to you kung aling technique yung gagamitin nyo. Basta piliin nyo lang yung mas madali sa inyo, okay? Anyway, ilalagdag ko lang ito. Balikan natin yung 3 plus 1 2/5. This is a whole number and a mixed number. Paano natin siya inadd? We just added the whole numbers. 3 plus 1 equals 4. Tapos we combine the answer to the fraction 2/5. So our final answer is 4 2/5. Ganun lang kadali yun.
I think not!
Now what if we have 3 1/5 plus 2/5? A mixed number and a fraction. Anong gagawin natin? Well, we just add the fractions. 1/5 plus 2/5. Similar sila, so we only add the numerators. 1 plus 2 equals 3. And we will get 3/5. Iko-combine natin ito sa whole number natin na 3. So our final answer is 3 3/5. Actually, pwede rin natin gamitin yung technique na iko-convert natin yung mixed number to improper fraction. Yung technique number 1. Obviously, mas matagal itong gawin. Pero kung type nyo to, sige lang.
Are you kidding?
And lastly, what if we have 3 plus 1/2? A whole number and a fraction. Ito ang sobrang simple. Common sense na lang. Iko-combine lang natin silang dalawa. 3 and 1/2. So our answer is 3 1/2. Now you try it.
You and me.
Add the following. Kung improper fraction yung lalabas na sagot, convert it to mixed number. Kung pwedeng i-reduce to lowest term, i-convert nyo. Ready? Begin. Are you finished? Let's check your answers. Number 1, 2 and 3 sevenths plus 3 and 1 seventh. Parehong mixed number. For this, gagamitin ko yung technique number 1. Iko-convert ko yung mga mixed numbers to improper fractions. Then, i-add ko. Mas madali yung technique number 2, pero gagamitin ko ito para may example kayo. So, let's convert. 2 and 3 sevenths. 7 times 2 equals 14. 14 plus 3 equals 17. So, 2 and 3 sevenths equals 17 over 7. Next, 3 and 1 sevenths. 7 times 3 equals 21. 21 plus 1 equals 22. So, 3 and 1 sevenths equals 22 over 7. Then, we will add 17 over 7 plus 22 over 7. We add the numerators. 17 plus 22 equals 39. So, we have 39 over 7. This is an improper fraction, so we will convert it to mixed number. 39 divided by 7 equals 5, remainder 4. So our final answer is 5 and 4 over 7. Number 2, 2 and 5 eighths plus 7 over 8. Isang mixed number sa isang fraction. For this, i-add lang natin yung fractions. 5 eighths plus 7 eighths. We add the numerators 5 plus 7 equals 12. So we have 12 over 8. Improper fraction ito, so we convert to mixed number. 12 divided by 8 equals 1, remainder 4. So we have 1 and 4 eighths. Pwedeng i-reduce to lowest term yung 4 eighths. Divisible ang 4 and 8 by 4. So 4 divided by 4 equals 1. 8 divided by 4 equals 2. So we have 1 and 1 half. Iko-combine lang natin ito sa whole number natin na 2. So 2 plus 1 and 1 half equals 3 and 1 half. That is our final answer. Number 3, 4 and 1 6 plus 8. Isang mixed number saka isang whole number. We will only need to add the whole numbers. 4 plus 8 equals 12. Tapos na. Our final answer is 12 and 1 sixth. Number 4, 5 and 2 thirds plus 6 and 1 half. Parehong mixed numbers. This time, gagamitin ko yung technique number 2. Whole number to whole number, fraction to fraction. And we add the whole numbers first. 5 plus 6 equals 11. Then we add the fractions, 2 thirds plus 1 half. Hindi sila similar, so magkocross multiply tayo. 2 times 2 equals 4. 3 times 1 equals 3. For the common denominator, 3 times 2 equals 6. So we have 4 6 plus 3 6. We add the numerators, 4 plus 3 equals 7. So we have 7 6. This is an improper fraction, so we convert it to mixed number. 7 divided by 6 equals 1, remainder 1. So we have 1 and 1 6. We combine this to the sum of the whole numbers. 11 plus 1 and 1 6 equals 12 and 1 6. Did you get everything correct? I hope so. Tsaga-tsaga lang yan. So before we end our lesson on addition of fractions, let me summarize everything. Aside from adding whole numbers, ito yung mga techniques na kailangan alam nyo. Addition of similar fractions. Using cross multiplication to change dissimilar fractions to similar fractions. Using LCD to change dissimilar fractions to similar fractions. Converting improper fractions to mixed numbers. Converting mixed numbers to improper fractions. Reducing a fraction to its lowest term. Kailangan may kopya kayo ng examples na mga yan para may reference kayo. Sorry. I hope you understand our lesson today. Alam ko, complicated ang addition of fractions, pero kaya nyo naman ito. Tsaga-tsaga lang. Just keep a copy of the notes and examples, okay? Tapos kapag may nalimutan kayong steps, tingnan nyo lang yung kopya nyo. Kung may hindi kayo nag-get sa video, you can replay the video and watch it again. Ulit-ulitin nyo lang, baka mag-gets nyo rin. You can also read the lesson notes of this video na nandun sa Google Classroom nyo. Baka mas maintindihan nyo kapag nakatype at hindi video. After that, you can proceed to work on your modules. Kung may questions pa rin kayo, tanongin nyo na lang yung teacher nyo during your discussion. So, goodbye for now. See you on the next video.